I don't believe it. I don't believe it. Here we are, right here, at the front gate, the front
door. I was just
thinking,
you know, this gate, it's been here for 25 years. You never changed it.
Oh, from 79, the pilot, it's all...
Yeah, well, that's 26 years.
Remember the first time we met?
Yes.
Do you?
Yes, it was Wonder Woman.
We did Wonder Woman together?
Initiate Project W36978.
Open time portal.
Cassandra, what are you doing?
I'm about to make all my knowledge of the 20th century pay off.
No!
Look like a giant silver condom. That's what your costume made you look like. I never told you that, but I have to share that with you now.
I think I would have put it more delicately.
No, that's what you look like. I'm sorry. And do you remember Bobby brought us back here from South Fork, to set up housekeeping here?
Yes.
I remember I wore this little girl dress and these white gloves and these little heels because Valene was so perfect. And she had the little pigtails and the ponytails.
Yes, that accent.
That accent. Well, I know. We decided after a while, let's drop the accent.
Why did we do that? Because nobody could stand it.
Could stand listening to me anymore. That was it.
And thank Miss Ellie for us, Bobby.
Now, come on, Val. She doesn't want any thanks. Now, ever since J.R. broke you two up, Mom and I, we've been looking for a chance to help out.
Oh, and tell Lucy.
Wait a minute now. I thought I wasn't supposed to tell Lucy anything.
You think we ought to bring Lucy here now, don't you?
Keeping the news of your remarriage from Lucy, I don't know. She's your daughter.
The marriage was so short the first time around. This time, Val and I have to know it's going to last, because if we bring Lucy here now and we can't hack it...
No, we'll make it. It's not going to take us long, neither.
What about your character, Gary, though? You were the pet, Miss Ellie's pet.
Well, I kept saying that, you know, but I never got that impression. In the first place, I only did about 4 episodes of Dallas, and I never thought I was that special to Miss Ellie.
They said you were the black sheep of the family.
Well, no, he was just a drunk.
Well, yeah, you were finding your way. You were finding your way, and it was Valley. Well, no, but...
Other ways of finding your way, other than ending up in alcohol.
I know.
What's the matter, Val? Don't you think I can handle a couple of drinks?
Well, sure. I just don't like drinking. You know that.
You think that little of me? Val, I can handle it.
I know, it's just that it's late, honey, that's all.
I haven't had a drink in 2 years, and you don't like the way I'm acting. Well, tough. Oh, or maybe you remember somebody better than all that time we were separated. Who was that, anyway? We never talked about that, did we?
You're the only man in my life.
I'm the man of this house, and I can handle a couple of lousy drinks. And if you don't like it, you can just trot your little bucket back to whoever rung your chimes.
Gary, now don't you talk like that, please.
I won't be talked down to in my own house.
Poor Val.
Poor Val. People used to ask me about, like I said, poor Val, why don't you go back? Because she's stupid, that's why.
No, she's not stupid. She was just finding her way. Because think of how she evolved from Goody Two Shoes
in
the
then
pilot.
You left me, then you married Doug Sheehan, and what happened? He died. Then you married that psychopath.
Sam Maleska.
Right.
And then it came back to you. But at each time, each notch on the tree, she became more and more her own person. And Valene is capable and has become capable of calling the shots. I think that's what's great.
Yeah, she did. She became her own person.
Yeah, she grew.
We've got to talk. I want to know exactly what is going on.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about you and Abby.
Val, please, you don't understand. We can talk. We have to talk. Honey, listen to me. Please, please. Don't do this. Do this. Come on. Val, please. No. We've been together too long. Listen. Come on. Valene. Damn it. Stop the car and listen to me. Val!
How much do you think that the fans wanted to see the two of us get
together?
Well,
I would get asked constantly, you know, when are they going to get back together? When are they going to get back together? I don't know. I don't write this stuff. But it was. It's one of the things that kept people watching the show.
Well, because you always keep the two characters apart that you want to see together
right.
the
never,
most.
Never put them together.
Never.
And if you do, make sure there's trouble and conflict and then maybe
tension,
they might go.
All kinds of things. But keep them coming back every Thursday at 10 o'clock.
It's like unrequited love.
Gotta kiss the bride.
Gary, I'm afraid that would cause a terrible scandal.
I hope you're happier with Ben than you've ever been in your life.
And you left the last season.
I did.
You died in this crash.
Or car crash.
Yes.
They wanted me to come back and right. do the car crash. They wanted me to go by in a drive-by, my little blonde head, so that you could react and see me explode.
Oh, my God.
What about the last episode? You thought I was dead.
Well, yeah, I buried you. Right?
And I dyed my hair black so that I could come back so that they would never know.
The character had gotten this note and with flowers or something that said...
Meet me.
Meet me, yeah.
Gary shows up.
Being the moron that he is, he showed up. Mm-hmm. And I'm sitting in this, it's a booth. It was a table with a booth. And I kind of look away and then I look back and you slid into the booth.
That's right, without you knowing the shot.
And I was just... I'm getting chills talking about it.
But see, that's the reconnection. That's the re...
It was incredible.
Gary. I had to make sure you weren't followed.
Val?
Yes.
Valerie?
Shh. Don't say anything. No one can know that I'm here. Or that you saw me. React. Don't do anything, Gary. Oh, God, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I have to do this to you. Don't. We can't talk here. No, I can't. It's too dangerous. It's too dangerous.
I'm letting you go.
The two of them were meant for each other, I think.
Obviously. I mean, I never figured that out. I just figured there was certainly a bond there that was unbreakable.
Mm. Gary and Val, now you see? This is what I'm talking about, the connection. It's there. Gary and Val became Joan and Ted in terms of the connection from the characters to the people, to the audience. And that's why they never wanted to see us apart. They never wanted to see us separated.
Well, I just hate it when my mascara runs.
Oh, I know it. Makeup, you see? See, that's what happens. But you know, that's what this place does.
No, it doesn't. It's just when I see you.
Oh! Well, I've made grown men cry many times.
Yes, I've heard of that. For a good time, Z. Jones, you'll make you cry.
I know. I'm here. I'm telling you. That's the thing about the two of us. And when we do the reunion in 5 years, the next one...
In 25 years?
No, five.
Five?
We may not last. 5 more years. But no matter what, I'm here for you. I'm here. Always will be. I love you so much.